through my products.
I am an animator.
I am a filmmaker. I develop trends.
I transform designs to reality.
I create environments.
I translate stories to furniture.
I design experiences.
I'm an immersive media designer.
I design mobility.
This is not only a design institute.
This is a design lab.
Join us in our design movement.
Hello, and a very warm welcome to the first edition of MITID webinar series. I'm your host, Arshia. I'm head of the Department for Fashion Design. Through this series of 12 webinars, we will try to enlighten design aspirants with various aspects of design as a profession. Today, we kick off our series with our first edition, and we have a very special guest with us today. We have Professor Anand Chakradev. He is the Dean of MIT Institute of Design. He has been instrumental in setting up MITID, Institute of Design at Pune, and he has been leading the team for last 26 years. A very warm welcome to you, sir.
Thank you, Arshia.
Through this session today, sir, we will try to answer the queries that the students and other participants will be posting in live through the webinar.
Okay.
We are also trying to clear up several misconceptions and myths about design education. We will focus on discussion on the opportunities in the field of design. We shall also be answering the questions that we commonly hear, like frequently asked questions in design education. So, sir, and folks who have joined us live today, let us start and begin this session with the first most common question that all of us have when we start and look at design education as a field where we will probably see our careers in.
Okay.
So, sir, what is the nature of design education in India? As in, how many institutes are there? What is the benchmark of taking admission? And should we look at a degree course, or should we look at taking admission in a diploma course? Can you please throw us some light on this discussion?
Oh, yes. Basically, there are three sub-questions here. One is about how design education started in our country, and then how it evolved, right? That way, it's a very new story, design education for our country, only around 50 to 60 years old. It all started in 60s when first India Design Report was written by Charles and Ray Eames. And afterwards, the installation and starting of National Institute of Design, which happened in 60s and early 70s. At that time, it was, there were very few design institutes. When we started, there was only one design institute. A few years later, Industrial Design Center, IIT Powai, was established. So few more design educators were added, few more design students were added. So till almost 2000, year 2000, the situation was almost same or similar, with very handful of design institutes and with very handful of design graduates coming out of that institute. Post 2000, the scene started changing slowly. Post 2008 or 10, the scene started changing very rapidly. And today, I would say there are around 70 plus design institutes. Maybe in another 2 years' time, we may reach 100 design institutes. So this is the scene about design education today. Because we started with National Institute of Design way back, and they were offering graduate diploma and postgraduate diploma at that time, for many years, most of the institutes were offering either graduate diploma or postgraduate diploma, and there was no concept of bachelor in design. But post 2000, the scene changed. Few institutes started operating and giving bachelor in design and masters in design. And now the scene is almost all design institutes operate on similar lines, and they either give Bachelor of Design and Master of Design, and very few of them are still hooked on to the earlier track of, I would say, diploma in design or postgraduate diploma in design. So, in short, this is what is the scene of design education today, and this is where we are. The second part of your question was about degree diploma, I suppose. Let me clear the fact here. When everyone was offering graduate diploma and postgraduate diploma, even industry was okay with graduate diploma and postgraduate diploma, and there was no issue about all those things. But now, since last 5 years, as it has changed, and now almost everyone is offering Bachelor in Design and Master in Design, I think that has become important. And now industry also expects that a person should have bachelor's degree in design or master's degree in design. So technically nothing has changed. I mean, the people are same. The designers which we are producing are almost same. The titles have changed. And these new titles are as per University Grants Commission. So the only authentic design degree, so to say, in our country is Bachelor of Design, which is 4 years, or Master of Design, which is 2 years.
So, sir, this sudden spurge in last 20 years, okay, I'm sure it has offered a lot of opportunities, as well also created some room for confusion.
Yes.
So what, according to you, is that differentiating factor that one has to identify while selecting design as an opportunity,
okay,
whether one chooses to do science or arts or design? Because there are so many times that students come up to us and they have this query that I'm weak in mathematics, so probably that's the reason why I would like to choose design as an opportunity. Mm-hmm. Do you think it justifies as being weak in maths or science to take design as a career, or is this a big myth that is around design education?
The answer can be yes or no. Yes and no, both. In fact, there are certain design disciplines which may, I would say, so to say, tolerate that you are not good in something, right? It need not be mathematics every time, but sciences definitely yes. But there are certain disciplines like industrial design discipline. If you are not good at science, if you don't understand scientific principles, if you are not good at logic, then you can still become an industrial designer, but then you will be competing with few others who are very good at that. And in long run, you may find some difficulties. So there is certainly importance of certain prerequisites or pre-education to join design. It should not be out of compulsion, and should not be because I don't like something, so I want to join design. It cannot happen like that. If you are not good at something, you will not be good here also. So it's no more a business of only right brain. Design is a whole brain activity, and when we say it is a whole brain activity, then what we want from an aspiring designer is good understanding of the other side of the brain also. He need not understand it means science or maths in mathematical terms, but he must understand it in, at least at principle level, at basic level, at least he should not hate it,
right,
to be honest. Yeah.
Right, sir. Thank you so much, sir. I think that gives you a very clear understanding that education in design also requires aspects of learning through mathematics or science. It's just that the principles, the application will vary. Sir, next question that we usually have, and okay, what comes across to us is that, how do you differentiate engineering vis-a-vis, you know, science as a profession, or vis-a-vis taking design up as a profession?
I put it in little different manner. I can give you comparison between art, engineering and design, if you want it in that fashion. See, art is, if I am an artist, it's my own expression. Whether my client, whether in general public will like it or not, I am least bothered about that. I am not, I don't do it for them, right? So art is my self-expression, and I am not bothered at all about who is going to consume it. If someone likes it, he or she will buy it. If they don't like it, that's fine with me. So that's not the case in design. In design, we start with user. So whatever we do as designers, whatever we tell our students to do as designers is finally for consumer. So every time they will have to look for consumer's aspirations. Every time they will have to work with certain constraints, but they will have to be very creative. So there is same amount of creativity required which an artist can have, but a design professional has to be or has to work with constraints. At the same time, he must understand user first. So this is how the artist and a designer, as far as their approach towards profession is. In engineering, it's all about scientific, I would say, proofs. It's all about mathematical support. It's all about mathematical modeling. It's all about equations which support whatever hypothesis which we are talking about. So there is very clear-cut difference between engineering and design. There is very clear-cut difference between design as and art. So someone wants to join design, I think the student will have to be careful, and they must understand whether they have all these qualities to join design or not.
Right, so that's very well explained, and I think it gives you a lot of understanding for all the people who have logged in today and trying to answer the queries. I would urge all of you to start posting your questions so that after a while when we start looking at and try and answer the queries that you will post in live. Sir, moving on, can you tell us a little bit about what are the opportunities? So I have done my design education. Okay, rather than going there, can we think of questions as in, should we take design as at an undergraduate level?
Okay.
Or should we take it up at a master's level? Because many a times we hear these questions that, okay, take bachelor's in engineering and then probably do master's in certain field of design. What are your views on this? Should it be at an undergraduate level or should it be at a postgraduate level?
Again, here the answer is yes and no, both. because it's very simple. If you want to join design, if you really want to join design, you join it at undergraduate level. If you have smallest doubt in your mind, the doubt can be about your capabilities as a person, about the understanding of the field itself, what is design, what is engineering, you are confused, you are not able to define both the things and you are not able to put yourself in that role. So if the confusion is about that, or if there are certain other issues from your parent side or from society side or from any other side, then I think you should think about doing something else first. And then probably think about design. There are some plus and minus points of both the tracks, I would say. As per my experience, this is completely my observation, I can tell you. Undergraduate students are better equipped with creative abilities. I mean, again, there is quite logical reasoning to that. Because they are not exposed to other things like technology, engineering, this, that, they don't carry any baggage. They can express their ideas freely without, you know, having fear of failure. Whereas if someone is an engineer, when he starts thinking about any concept, he cannot forget that he is an engineer. The engineering part, the material part, the manufacturing processes part starts coming in his or her mind at the time when he starts thinking on the concept. So there is a lot of baggage which they carry when they are graduate in some area and then they join design, and it's very difficult for them to unload that baggage. They always carry that baggage. And so their creative capabilities, it will be a bold statement, but are not as good as undergraduate students. But How about industry? How industry looks at it? Industry wants both of them. There are certain areas, there are certain projects where industry feels that even if the project is not manufacturable, so to say, they would like to go for it because they get some great ideas through that interaction. So in certain cases, industry looks for people who will not have or who need not have that baggage. In certain cases, industry wants them to be engineer first or some fine artist first or architect first and then be designers, because industry then can use their both knowledge bases effectively. So as I answered initially, if you want to join design, if that is firm, join it at undergrad level.
So if you are really passionate about design,
yes,
and you really feel that that is where your career lies and you see yourself as a designer, you start attempting and preparing for it at the undergraduate level itself, because it gives you a good amount of time, that is 4 years, to pursue your dream, to find yourself and your creative expression in the field of design. Our next question is, sir, should design be pursued at when you're pursuing it in for a design education at undergraduate level or postgraduate level, should you choose to do it in India or choose for options that are abroad?
It all depends on individual's capacity. I'm not saying financial capacity, because there are so many in India especially, there are so many touch points on the basis of which the final decision about education, whether it is at undergrad level or at master's level, is taken. Both have different, world give different experiences. Design education in India is very good. It's deep rooted, so there is no doubt about quality of design education in India. But if someone wants to get that world view of design at undergraduate level itself, and if he's financially sound, if he can afford to go at undergraduate level, and if he's mature enough to go there and study design, I think it can be done even at undergraduate level. Having said this, even if someone is doing design education at undergraduate level in India, my suggestion will be he or she should spend at least one semester abroad. That gives him or her a very different perspective about design. His entire opinion changes, his entire approach towards design changes. So it is always good to get exposure, world exposure, when you are studying design, may it be in India, may it be abroad. But if someone has done design education in India at undergraduate level, it is advisable to go for masters outside India.
Thank you, sir. I think that gives you a fair idea in terms of whether you should start off in India or abroad. Opportunities are endless and choices are endless. I think it's more about selecting based on several parameters like finances, your ability to stay abroad, and being independent away from your parents and family. Sir, one very important...
There is one more thing in it. There is a midway also.
Okay.
There are certain programs available in certain design institutes which allow you to spend 2 years in India and then allow you to go abroad for next 2 years. This is sort of called as twinning programs or articulation agreements which these institutes sign with institutes abroad. So if someone or if some parents feel that their kids are not matured enough to send them abroad at the age of 18.
Immediate.
They can spend 2 years here, and at the age of 20 or 21, they can go abroad, complete their undergraduation there, and get that international degree. So this is, I would say, golden mean, where you can achieve base. You can learn base in India, which is very strong base. Foundation programs in our country are very strong, and then get exposure to world view of design.
So, sir, the institutes will specify when they have such training programs, yes, and it will be mentioned very clearly.
Yes, almost all the institutes mention it on their websites. In MIT Institute of Design also it is mentioned on the website, and people can look for it and get benefit of both the things.
That's fantastic. Yeah. That sounds like a good news and a midway path for students who want to get both global as well as the Indian aspect of design. Sir, next question is, I think, one of the most important questions that most of our students face and are continuously looking for queries and answers. What is this design selection process? How do you enter a design institute? What are the parameters? What is this entrance exam? And how do you crack entrance exam? And how do you attempt the personal interviews? It sometimes sounds very exhaustive process, or sometimes it may be simple, but it's made to look very exhaustive. Sir, can you please throw some light on this?
Yes, it is exhaustive process. It doesn't look simple, and it is not simple also, both.
Okay.
So, unfortunately, we don't have up till now common entrance exam like engineering or like medicine in our country. So, at present, we are relying heavily on exams conducted by individual institutes or group of institutes. So, at present, students are supposed to give all those, qualifying exams. What we look for when we select any student for design education is most important, and how do we achieve that? We want to get students who have very creative bent of mind. They may not be good at skills. They need not, I would not say that, but they may not be good at skills, doesn't matter, because entire foundation program takes care of those skills. But if their mind is not present, if they are not good at that, if they are not good at thinking, if they cannot think differently, if they cannot think creatively, I think then it is very difficult to mold them. So skills can be molded, but mind cannot be molded beyond certain limit. That's why we look for students who have good mind, who have good approach towards this area of design, and who have very clear creative intent to join this creative profession. Now, how do we achieve that? I mean, it's really difficult for us also to, analyze it and select the students on the basis of it, but we need some methods for that, and we have devised some methods. So, generally, the first exam, which is qualifying exam, which is design aptitude test, we call it as, is to check the aptitude of a student towards creative fields. So, what it covers is generally, something related to logic, something related to design awareness, something related to general knowledge, then something related to theory, basic understanding, and little bit of sketching. So we try to check the aptitude through this first screening exam. Once that happens, once someone qualifies through that and goes for the next step, then there are tests, we call it as studio test, wherein the skills are checked, because design is all about skills and the thought process, so, and the aptitude. So, we check aptitude in first test, we check the skills in studio test, we check leadership quality, interpersonal skills, few other skills in those studio tests and the situation tests which we conduct. Once all these things are done, we call that candidate for the interview. So, at the time of interview, we check whether whatever he has written in his exam or whatever he has, performed at the time of those tests, whether it is right, whether it is perfect. We just cross-check it by asking few questions, and at the same time, we get an opportunity to interact with that student in person. So, we just cross-check few things in that interview. casually because they come up with so called portfolio, we go through that portfolio to check and verify the creative skills of that student, and then we either select or reject that student. So as I said initially, it is complicated process. Yes, it is not a simple process, but one should not be more worried about it. If you really want to join design, if you really feel that you have that creative element within you, then you should not be worried about what will be there in the test and how I should give my interview and how I should clear my situation test. It automatically happens if your intent is right.
So that is so well explained that each institute will have its own way of processing your exams.
Yes.
And taking you through the process of admission. What's important for all of you to know is that be very clear, understand, be in touch with the institute, try and read their rules, regulations. There
yes.
will be certain test papers and other information that will be available on that institute's website. Do visit it and read about it. Understand, speak to the people of that institute, speak to the seniors who are already in that institute and currently undergoing those courses. It will give you a very clear understanding.
Absolutely right.
Now, sir, when you mentioned that one specific word, that is portfolio, okay. It brought some questions to my mind.
All right.
Do you think a portfolio is mandatory for an undergraduate student, or is it just for postgraduate students?
Portfolio is not at all mandatory for undergraduate student, but at the same time, you know, it is a competition. When I have 100 students in front of me to select from, and there are 50 students who are of same capability but have portfolio also, then I will be happy to go through their portfolio. There are misconceptions about what should be there in that portfolio. There are many institutes outside who train the students to appear for these entrance exams, and then they give some guidelines about how to prepare portfolio. See, what happens is when 10 students join one particular center, training center for these things, then all 10 portfolios start looking same. That
it's
should
like
not happen.
A copy paste.
That should not
which,
happen.
Which is not desired.
So portfolio should reflect your personality as a student. Portfolio should allow us to check your growth as a creative person. So how good you were in, let's say, when you were in 10th or in 8th and in 11th and in 12th, if you are able to tell us your progress through some sketches or some other means, That's the definition of portfolio. And at undergraduate level, very frankly speaking, we don't expect a structured, discipline-specific portfolio, because we know that at that level, they even don't understand anything about design, forget about the discipline. So, but if they have some good sketches, some paintings which they have drawn, some photography work which they have done, some pottery work which they have done, some origami work which they have done, any other work which, or poetry which they have done, if they have written some blogs, if they have written some articles, I think that should build the whole portfolio, because we want to see them as creative people. We don't want to see what their training institutes have trained them to get into design education. Having said this, at master's level, portfolio is must, because at master's level, you are applying for a particular discipline. When you apply for a particular discipline, we test you on the basis of that particular discipline only. So, for example, if you are applying for transportation design and if you don't show us a single sketch of a car, how can we say that you are eligible to join transportation design discipline? Or you are applying for fashion design program at master's level and you are unable to show any garment which you have made on your own out of curiosity, we clearly say that you are not eligible or not interested in joining that. So, at undergraduate level, any creative work can be treated as portfolio. at master's level, it has to be very well structured, discipline specific, so that we can judge them very quickly and happily accept them as our students.
So, sir, that is, I think you have clarified very in so many words, given us so much information, which is so valuable in terms of understanding that portfolio is not just a huge big file with several sheets of drawing and photographs or, you know, craft hobby things. It's about you as an individual. It's your reflection. It's your thought process. It's what you want others to see, what you want the selection board to see. So, accordingly, please plan at undergraduate level. Don't stress yourself for creating portfolios that are not a true reflection of yourself, but certainly at master's level, bring something that clearly shows who you are and what would you like to do for your master's program.
Exactly.
Sir, having said this, we understand now that what is the size of design colleges and the number of opportunities in India, abroad, what kind of programs. You have also very properly explained us the selection process. Now, after all this, we have entered, say, design education and finished those 4 years, those precious 4 years or those precious 2 years.
Yes.
What happens after that? What is the scenario? Is, I don't see, or we have not, many parents come up to us and say that there is like a medical industry, or there is like a engineering industry,
or automotive
industry, or IT industry or field. We don't see design. I mean, we, there's no like a board you see that says design.
Industry.
You enter this design industry. So what is it? Can you tell us what are the opportunities? What are not just opportunities? What are the hurdles? How do you get into this entire field or profession of design? How do you take it up after you have studied it for 4 years or say 2 years?
See, whether you study it at 4 years or 2 years, it doesn't matter. What matters is how well you have done, how well you perform after studying design, either for 4 years or 2 years. So it is a profession of performance. If we talk about medical profession, we'll not go to a doctor who is mediocre doctor, right? Or we'll not go to an architect who doesn't know how to design buildings, or a mediocre architect. So it's about performance. Or a lawyer probably who doesn't have enough knowledge of law. So design is about performance. It is about your portfolio. It is about the projects which you have handled in either 4 years or 2 years. That will finally lead you to industry. Your question is right. We don't see that this is design industry. We don't see any board like that. The implied meaning of that is design is present everywhere. We don't see it because it is within an industry. It is one part of industry. It has various formats in terms of, I would say, size of the industry, type of industry, because design covers so many areas. Like in terms of disciplines, we have everything starting from animation design up to fashion design, maybe user experience design, product design, interior design, retail design. There are so many disciplines. That's why there is a variety in industry also. Industry is of multiple types, I would say. There are small time design studios which employ one or two designers. There are some design studios which employ up to 50 or 60 designers, and they take up jobs for their multinational clients, or they get into development of their own products or systems or services probably. Third level of industry is design departments of multinationals or design departments of industry. So, in addition to this, there are animation firms, there are film studios, there are media firms, then there are architectural firms, there are, small level art studios. So, all these people consume design. So they recruit design students or designers at either multiple levels or in multiple numbers also. Nowadays, another big opportunity for all design students, all design students, any discipline design student has come up, which is user experience design. most of the software industries require designers in huge numbers. So they select any discipline designer and then they train them on user experience design and use them for developing graphic user interfaces and all those areas. So size wise, I would say it's a huge industry. At the same time, there is a word of caution here. Because it is a area where you are supposed to perform and grow, if you are not good at that, you may not get good opportunity. But if someone is really good, if someone has a really strong portfolio, I think every such student might have 2-3 opportunities at a time. So and don't go by the reports, because there are so many reports which are being generated these days about industry size, but not a single report I have observed which is able to give right size of the industry, because it is not available at one particular setup. It is existing in so many variants of it. The opportunities are in so many variants of it that it's literally difficult to find out the size of the industry. But I can guarantee you, I can confidently say that if someone is really a good designer, there are multiple opportunities available for that particular designer. It depends on his or her own capability, what salary, what pay package, what further opportunities he or she can get. But certainly there are multiple opportunities available right now. And this is in fact the best time to join design education, because after 4 years or after 2 years from now, when you graduate, when the student graduate, few more opportunities will be there in existence.
So India is now at the core of design. It's become like a hub where it's progressing and pushing the limits in terms of getting design into different various roles, as Professor Chakradev has explained through his conversation with us. Sir, one question that comes to our mind is that, so we are living in this current scenario where industries, we hear different news, and you said there are multiple opportunities. This is about present. What about the future? Is design going to grow at this same pace, or will there be some level of stagnation, or would the roles change, and does the design education in India currently prepare us to deal with those changes, to deal with the future needs of design?
Yes, there are two points here. One, whether it will grow with same speed or whether there will be stagnation. I think it's industry cycle. So industry cycle always has some ups, some downs, and some periods where there is a stagnation. Same thing will happen, might have happened earlier, might happen in future also for design. So design skill sets which are applicable today, or the qualities which are applicable from designer's side today, may not be applicable tomorrow. For simple reason, the nature of job itself, the nature of opportunities, the nature of jobs will not be the same which is there today. My advice to design aspirants is try to be multitasking as far as possible. We started, once upon a time, design was craft based design. So entire activity was oriented towards craft or based on craft. After manufacturing intervention, after manufacturing growth of manufacturing industry, I think the technology component came in, and it became the design activity which we see today. The future of technology is changing very fast. So the future of design also will change very fast. So at present, if a designer has that multitasking ability, I think his survival in future will be better, because he will adapt himself or herself to the latest changes in technology. Another important thing is you cannot, as a designer, you cannot run away from technology or changes in technology. Every day now it's virtual reality, mixed reality, machine learning, IoT is there, and so many new things, blockchain technology is coming up. So there are so many new things in terms of disruptive technologies which is happening in that domain. If designer is not aware of it or is not interested in knowing it, I think there will be a danger zone for that particular designer. But if a designer is ready to adopt these new situations or is or having this multitasking ability, I think he or she will have bright future. But the role of a designer is certainly changing. Designer used to design. That was the well-defined role which a designer was following for all these days. What is to be designed? I think those things are changing very fast. And that's why new disciplines, completely new disciplines, which we have not heard up till now are coming up. So there is good scope now for service design. There is a good scope for user experience design. Experiential design. I think these are the new terminologies which are coming up, which are becoming very popular, and these are opening new avenues for a designer. So if designer decides to sit in ivory tower and do whatever he is expert in, I think or she will not be able to embrace this future which is so close and which is changing so fast. We can see designers at multiple roles these days. You can see designers at municipal corporations. You can see designers at political organizations. Entire campaigns are planned and designed by some designers. So there are changing roles. Designers are seen as strategists. They design strategies for many activities which are happening. So if you treat design as a problem solving process rather than getting into some sort of discipline and sticking to that particular discipline, I think there are multiple opportunities available, and then you can handle the future, which is so dynamic, which is so technology driven, which is so changing very fast.
So I think, sir, you have put it very well that the role of a designer is multifaceted. It's ever changing, ever growing. The opportunities are endless for the one who is ready to yes. change and adopt. Sir, I think that gives us quite a bit of understanding of what design is, what is happening in the field of education, career opportunities. I think now should we start taking up some questions from yes. our live audience?
Of course, yes.
Can we go and see what, okay. So that's the first question from Priyanka Goyal. She's from Chandigarh.
Okay.
She wants to know whether one should take up job after doing bachelor's in design or go straight away to master's and then a job.
Once you are bachelor in design, you are technically eligible for taking up a job in design. So ideally, it will be good to take up a job for 1 or 2 years. Understand further whether and what type of super specialization or specialization in design you want to go for, or you want to change the track a bit and get into strategy or design management or something of that sort. And with full understanding about what exactly you want to do at master level, one can join masters. And the experience, of course, opens up the whole thing, and it gives you different exposure about design and helps you in selecting master's program. So it is always advisable to work for 2-3 years before going for master.
Okay, sir. Next question is from Lokit Poddar from New Delhi. Okay. And he wants to know, can a commerce background student get into design?
Yes, of course, why not? See, there are two different things. One is eligibility and another is capability. Eligibility wise, yes, of course. Once you have cleared your 12th and you have passed your 12th, you are certainly eligible to get into design education, any stream, so to say, science or arts or commerce stream can join undergraduate program. But there is something called as capability. So I'm not saying that commerce students are not capable. It doesn't depend on whether he is a commerce student or art students or science student. If it is there, it is there. If it is not there, it's not there. So the capability has to be there along with eligibility. This is at undergraduate level. At master's level, we look for certain prerequisites. Like someone wants to join, let's say, product design. We expect that he should at least have engineering degree or architecture degree or science degree, because there are so many scientific principles which are involved, or engineering principles which are involved in product design activity. So at master's level, one should check for those prerequisites. But at bachelor's level, for bachelor's level admissions, I think anyone can join, but one must think about capability rather than eligibility.
So Lokit, that answers your question. You can surely apply for design, but if you are applying at an undergraduate level, you can surely do it. But at postgraduate level, you please visit the website of the desired institute and check the eligibility criteria. Next question we have from Siddhi Patil, who is from Sangli, and she wants to know, what are the skills that need to focus on getting into fashion communication, and also what are the career prospects after fashion management?
I think, Arshia, you are from fashion design department, so you better answer that question. It will be good. But fashion communication is a communication design discipline, and any skill set which is true for communication design, I suppose it's true for fashion communication also, but you are the right person to answer that.
Right, sir. So, Siddhi, for your fashion design requirement that you are saying that for fashion management, it's a very vast field, and in many courses you will find that fashion management is being offered at a master's level, because you need to have a prerequisite of understanding either of fashion design, fashion communication, to understand fashion management. Having said that, in many a times in your undergraduate level also, you may specialize by taking fashion management as your graduation project. Fashion communication is a vast and ever-changing, ever-evolving and fast-growing field currently in the fashion industry. So all the aspects relating to communication of fashion or a brand or a retail will happen through fashion communication, be it your advertisements or be it your styling, even your photo shoots, commercials is all done by fashion communication stylists and fashion communication graduates. So that answers
you. Here is one word of caution for her. Again, she should not join fashion communication because she feels that it is much softer than the hard work which is required in
fashion design. Absolutely.
So if that is the approach, then it might not work in fashion communication also. The
Surely.
Intent has to be very clear.
We always say that it's not the easy way out. You do not choose something because you think it's easy. Turns out that it requires a lot of hard work than what you think or you thought that it would need or need not.
Yeah.
Okay, so next question we have from Rucha Kulkarni, and she wants to know the prerequisite for entering into design field. I think that Richa Kulkarni, we have already answered that question, sir.
Prerequisite for undergraduate, I told you. For masters, every discipline will have different prerequisite. For communication design, for example, fine arts, applied arts, even science or arts background, literature background, they can be best fit for communication design disciplines. For industrial design disciplines, engineering graduates, architects, science graduates will be best fit for those disciplines. At master level, we will have to be very particular about these prerequisites, because for two reasons. One, we don't have that much time to train them on basics. Master's program is of 2 years. out of that 1 year, one semester goes in the industry for final thesis project. So practically we have 3 semesters with us, and it's very short time to train them on basics. So prerequisites has important role in at the level of masters. At undergrad, I think they should be as raw as possible with basic skills, so that they are moldable and we will be able to mold them in our own way.
So Richard, that answers your question, and we have a next question from Jason Pinto, and he wants to know the difference between BDes and BFA. So okay. Bachelor of Design and Bachelor of Finance.
As per UGC nomenclature, this is little technical, but I'll have to explain it like that only. As per UGC nomenclature, the only design degree which they consider as design degree is Bachelor of Design, which is 4 years Bachelor of Design program. Bachelor of Fine Arts is a fine arts degree which actually takes them through various programs like sculpting, painting type of program, which makes them specialized in those particular art areas. There are certain schools which run applied art program under BFA, which is very similar to communication design bachelor's program, but not exactly same as Bachelor of Design in communication design, but it is quite similar. See, the nomenclature is because of the fact that fine arts education started quite early as compared to design education in our country. So when fine arts education started, the BFA degree was coined, and some of them went for applied arts, which was very close to design. But when design degrees were coined, and when so many design institutes are there and so many design institutes are offering design degrees, I think if someone wants to get into design, it's better to get into Bachelor in Design rather than going for Bachelor in Fine Arts. There is a difference.
There is a difference. So certainly there is a difference, Partha, and you need to look at the course offerings. You need to ensure that you make up your mind whether you want to get into the field of design or fine arts. Based on that, you can take your decision.
Yes.
Next question we have is, what is a better decision for joining either a BDes in transportation design or a product or industrial design, considering today's design scenario or industry scenario?
I think this is again one more misconception that today some discipline is having more opportunities and few other disciplines don't have those opportunities. It's not about that, it's about who you are and what you exactly want to do in your life. See, if someone wants to be a transportation designer, and if he leaves his entire life as that, and he dreams about that, there is no point in joining product design. Even if, let's assume, it is not the fact, let's assume that there is no single job available in product design. After that also, if someone wants to join product design, he will join product design. So it's on you. You'll have to understand your own capabilities. You'll have to understand what you would like to do in your rest of the life and join any particular discipline, instead of checking whether this discipline has a better potential or the other discipline has. That generally happens in engineering. Once upon a time, mechanical engineering was the best possible discipline for everyone to join. Today it is computer science. So everyone wants to join computer science without checking whether their aptitude tells them to join computer science or not. But that doesn't work in design. So if you really want to get into some discipline, join it without any doubt. There are good opportunities available for all good designers. There are no opportunities available for mediocre designers. It is as simple as that.
So that's a harsh truth, Parth,
yes.
That you have to see, you have to decide not based on what are the current industry trends, but you have to see what are the ever-changing roles of a designer and where does the true intent or passion of that person is. I hope that gives you a little bit of direction in trying to understand what to take as a future prospective discipline while you select your design discipline. Okay, so we have next question from, we have a question from Manish Desai, and he wants to know, is there a specific stipulated curriculum by UGC?
See, UGC doesn't decide or prepare any curriculum. That responsibility is given to university, and through university that responsibility is given to academic council and board of studies. In board of studies, there are expert members from that particular discipline, domain, design, from few other disciplines, and they take that responsibility. I think the question is about standardization of curriculum. I think design cannot have standardization process in their curriculum, because the things which a designer is supposed to know remain same. The way in which it is taught, the sequence of that particular course, it's completely left to the institute as per the institute's philosophy. Like in MIT Institute of Design, we have 1 year foundation. There are certain institutes which run 6 months foundation. There are certain institutes which don't have foundation. But that doesn't mean they don't teach those basic skill sets which are required for a particular person to become a designer. So, there is no standardization of curriculum. In fact, it is a very good thing which has happened for design education, that there is no standardization. Having said this, there are certain, formats, certain structures which are very common across all design institutes, and if you select any particular discipline for that matter, the number of courses or the any particular course which you are undergoing will remain same. The title may be different, but whatever is taught almost remains same across all the design institutes. So it's good to have that freedom and flexibility for design educators to decide their own curriculum, so that the curriculums are relevant to the need of the industry, the curriculums are relevant to the discipline and the whole education pedagogy of that institute or a university.
So, sir, the institute will have like some kind of authorization from UGC. It will have some kind of certification that says that this institute is authorized to conduct design education formally under the rules and regulations specified?
No, UGC allows universities to decide that. Universities are created for that. Universities are allowed to decide their own courses which they want to offer or run. What we as educators or university people are supposed to do is, we are supposed to stick to some basic guidelines which are given by UGC. I mean, there has to be board of studies which should decide the curriculum. There has to be academic council which should approve the curriculum. There has to be governing council which should further approve it. And there has to be some templates. The curriculum should be in this format. There should be choice-based credit system. There should be electives. There should be minimum number of credits, maximum number of credits. So, University Grants Commission gives templates, basic templates, minimum number of hours, maximum number of hours, and universities are supposed to decide that. One more thing universities follow and everyone should follow is the titles created by UGC. So, if it is design degree, UGC has titles given. So, UGC says if you want to offer design degree, it should be Bachelor of Design, 4 years, Master of Design, 2 years. So, those things we all follow and we are supposed to follow. Otherwise, for rest of the things, universities have a lot of freedom that way.
Okay, sir. So, we have next question from Arushi Bhalla, who is from Jalandhar. So, she, well, it's a very long question. I don't have impressive drawing skills. However, okay, I like to think out of the box. Okay. Is Design College the place for me?
All right. So, to make it simple, I'll put that question once again. I'm not good in sketching. Can I still become a good designer? Answer, if I'll put it further, if you have fantastic sketching skills, drawing skills, can you become good designer? Answer can be maybe or may not. Because for design, the sketching skills is one of the skills which are required to become a designer. You can become a good fine artist if you have great sketching skills. But you may or may not become good designer if you have good sketching skills, or if you don't have good sketching skills, then also you can become a good designer. What we want is, there are certain, in design education, there are certain things about thinking process. So we want a student who has good mind. We are here to develop skills. So even if there are no good skills available with any student, doesn't matter. Entire foundation program is there to hone those skills and bring that student up to certain level and then take him forward further. So I think that's only one of the criteria which decide whether to join design or not. In fact, this is a misconception. Some parents and some students feel that they are very good at drawing and they can directly join design. That's not true.
Yeah. So Arushi, you need not worry too much about your non-impressive drawing skills, but I think you can still focus on thinking out of the box. You can think of joining a design college, research about it, and try and understand what is the process. We have already given you a lot of information as to how do you proceed, what is the path you can take. Okay, so all the best for your further pursuing design education. We have next queries in terms of specific disciplines that how could you choose a discipline after foundation? So is there a specific way that it happens, or does the institute guide you in selecting a discipline?
Yes. First of all, the admission is not given to any particular discipline, because after 12th, they are not at all aware about design. So forget about discipline, they are certainly not aware and know anything about the discipline which they intend to join. So the admission is given to foundation program. Foundation program is first year of design education, which is common to all design disciplines. So they undergo various skills, we hone their skills, may it be material skills, may it be sketching skills, rendering skills, understanding of color, sensitizing them towards color and sensitizing them towards form, spaces. So all these courses happen in first year. In entire 1 year, there is a lot of hand-holding. So, they interact with peers, they interact with faculty members, they interact with senior students, they understand what seniors are doing being in that particular discipline. And then with full understanding of that particular discipline, full understanding of their own capabilities, they try to match those capabilities and the requirements of that particular discipline. And then they choose their discipline. In MIT Institute of Design, at least there is no upper cap on number of students joining any particular discipline. But there are certain institutes where that cap is there. They have their own process. But there also the foundation program remains same. So there is a lot of hand-holding in first year to choose your discipline. At present, the most important decision in life is whether to join design or not to join design. If the answer is yes, I think students should not be worried about discipline at this stage. Let them join design. They get complete 1 year to decide about their discipline. And that's a nice process, I would say, to select one discipline, because finally you try to remain in that particular discipline for throughout the life, or you actually grow in that particular discipline. So sufficient time is given to select that discipline.
Right, sir. On a last note, can you tell us a little bit about MIT Institute of Design and what are the opportunities that MIT offers to design aspirants?
Instead of MIT Institute of Design, I would say it is MIT Design. And under MIT Design, we have 4 universities right now. So MIT Institute of Design, which is constituent of MIT Art, Design and Technology University. We have design program at Ujjain under Avantika University. We have design program at our 3rd university, which is located in Guwahati, MIT University, Meghalaya. And we have 4th design program in our Autonomous Engineering College under Pune University, and that program also offers design. In terms of offerings, I think we have almost all disciplines, right from product, transportation, interior, retail, animation, film, you can say in fashion, we have fashion design, fashion communication, we have game design. So we have user experience design. So we have almost all disciplines at undergraduate level and at master's level. We have started PhD program in design. The most important feature of this entire MIT group is we have only one common entrance exam. We call it as Design Aptitude Test, DAT, and that one common entrance exam allows you to get into 4 different units of MIT group which offer design education. So we say that it is one entrance exam and you can be eligible to get into 4 design institutes. So that's what we offer as MIT Institute of Design, and we are one of the sought after design institutes in the country, and we are happy for that, and that's the reason why we get very good students in our institute.
I think so that's a fantastic news, not just for us but also for all the future design aspirants, that you enter one design aptitude test and you have a wide array to choose from 4 different universities.
Yes.
Sir, I would, I want to thank you profusely for your time, your patience and giving us so much information. I think that it was very, you were very transparent in terms of sharing your thoughts and your experiences with us. And it has certainly been of a huge benefit to the viewers who are with us, and surely this webinar is also available on other channels where students can look up and understand what's happening in design education and how to pursue it. Thank you very much, sir, for your time. And to all our audience who is here logged in with us, I want to tell you that this is the first episode of our webinar series. We have many more coming up, precisely 11 more. Stay tuned on our website www.mitid.edu.in. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram on our handle, and you shall be posted about all the series of developments. The next webinars will be very specific on designs, design disciplines that you would like to choose. So this is Arshia signing off, and hope you had a good time and understood your queries. Cheers. All the best.
Thanks a lot.